Okay, so tonight we're doing a reading. This is for the general collective. However, this resonates. King of Swords, Six of Swords, and the World in Reverse. So somebody who's refusing to let go, this could be a karmic tie. This could be someone that you were just in a relationship or close with. King of Swords is the truth. Six of Swords is something about feeling walking away and obligated. And you can't release this person because you're in a world of reverse. What else is going on? Nine of Wands, feeling the burden, feeling weighed down by it or tied to something from the past that you can't release or feel like you can't. You have no control over being released. The Magician manifesting. Someone feels like they can't let you go. This could be your person. This is your person speaking on the general plane. Some of the Cups, the Magician. Someone could be doing magic, or you could feel like they're doing magic against you to keep the soul bind in contact. This doesn't generally have to be the case. In the Four of Cups, somebody is refusing to let go, but also. This isn't the Pentacles, this is a cup, so this is for them. Knight of Pentacles, someone rushing in with a message. Seven of Wands is territory. Someone is refusing to, somebody is pushing on defense, on the defense is what I want to say. The Chariot. Moving forward, moving in pursuit steadily, could be quickly, could be abruptly. But it's not so with this Page of Cups here. So, somebody has a message they want to deliver to you. This is Four of Wands here. This could be your soulmate. But you guys are in separation due to the fact that somebody is refusing this proposal or offer because they're blind and they don't want to. They were closed off. And not letting the relationship flow in the way it was supposed to happen. The Five of Swords. Three of Conflicts. Competition. Change. What's that conclusion here? What's the conclusion? What's the outcome for this reading? Okay, we have a lot of cards. I just want to fly. But we have the Six of Cups. So this is coming together. I'm going to put these cards back. Is juggling, balancing something that is an equal give and take. So that has to be the number one focus here is loyalty. Make sure there's no third parties going on, no deception or deceit. Wheel of Fortune, Hangman, needing to see things from a new perspective. The Five of Wands, conflict, again, number Seven of Swords. Eight of Swords, feeling stuck in your head and trapped. Somebody was jealous or the envious type. Someone could have been playing the victim role. We have the Knight of Swords, Six of Wands, Victory, and the Hermit, Virgo energy. Someone was only seeing things, they were blindsided to what they wanted to see. Deceit, envy. This is coming in right and clear for these cards here. This is the overall love, general messages, reading. We have the Three of Wands here, so we can just look in a new direction. Two of Wands. Not escapable from the past, not escapist, okay? So this to me is someone who is redundant, reluctant, and knows the truth, knows who this person is, knows already. They don't want to see it though. They're being blindsided, they're being stubborn, they're being, because love and emotions are getting in the way here, yeah. This could possibly be the Virgo you're dealing with. This Temperance card, balance, there is no balance because someone is being deceitful. I don't want to say that. Choosing to negotiate or look at things from another person's perspective here. Ten of Pentacles, yeah, maybe someone was just after you because of his coin, but so they thought. So good. Okay, what else is coming in? It's the Seven of Cups energy. It's the Seven of Cups energy that we're dealing with here. The Nine of Swords. Depleted, defeatation, grief, sorrow, hopelessness. They feel, in a way, in a sense, that things can't be fixed, or that there's no use in trying, in a general manner. The Magician, we have Four of Swords, waiting, contemplating. Okay. Things burn beneath the surface, which we already know what's already there. We already know what's there. Inner knowing, inner truth has been said, spoken, or seen through visual eyes or within your soul's general vision. That enough can be said for visual eyes, because that's your soul language, your lingo, your vibration, what it radiates at. So inner knowing, but inner truth has been spoken. Four of Cups, we have the Five of Cups. So you're upgrading a level of decency. You're coming out of that. You're contemplating. You've been in a cocoon, so to speak, and now you're radiating and glowing from home love, because your soul has generated and gone through it. What do I want to say? In patterns. You've already, accomplished and programmed and went through the outdated system, so to speak. Outdated old patterns no longer, the beliefs are no longer working, are there, they're no longer there. So the Knight of Pentacles, we have the Emperor. Okay, this is Aries energy. This is someone who no longer dictates or tries to morphine of their past existence. They're over this. They're over the Pentacles. They're over moving, coming in slow. They're stepping up. They're taking the lead. Okay? And then we have the Two of Cups on the Seven of Wands. The Seven is up the Vine. Who's the Seven here? Okay. And then for the Chariot, we have the Death card. No longer moving towards your person anymore. Because you know it's going to be the same old karmic patterns. You're not playing that game anymore. This isn't your role, this wasn't your purpose, isn't your purpose anymore. It's to come to their beck and call. We have the Knight of Wands over the Page of Cups. We know the fire sign, this could be you. Your sign. And the Metamorphosis, the Four of Wands, we have the Page of Cups. You're waiting for somebody who is strong, noble, and is able to crack your code, so to speak. And then this union between the departure of you both, and you don't want to go back to the same old. We have the Five of Wands with the Six of Cups. So you're kind of downgraded in a sense, but not really, because you're still keeping this person at bay, but you're coming towards your truer self, your divine plan and purpose. So really, in a sense, you're doing it for yourself. Yeah, with the Star card here. And you're not backing down. With the Nine of Pentacles, this is your true inner being, your light, yourself. This is independence. You're gravitating towards who you are and your sense of dignity and who you're supposed to be. nobody really else, I feel like, gets that, because you both are of the same source, the same signature. You're divinely guided here, and your path, heaven, whatever that, however that resonates with you. Okay, we have the Queen of Cups, and we have the Devil card, Capricorn energy, Leo, Aries, and Sagittarius. So somebody wants you to take their fruits, but you know that they may be toxic, or not. They're right, but they may not be fruitful in the long term, because if somebody is still arrogant and boastful and is a narcissist or has huge ego, how could they be beneficial to your life path and your purpose, soul purpose? It's been part of the plan since all along. And you know, you already know that it's not good, it's not in your best interest. That's what you've been avoiding this whole time. Let's see what else. So what's this game of swords here? All these cards are gonna come out and I'm reversed. Something ain't right. Somebody's been spinning either. Gossip, or could possibly be dirt on your name, and I'm saying that in small fractions because I don't want to cut to conclusions or cut to the chase or anything in demeanor. But you never know with this person, because at this point they've done you wrong so many times, you don't know what to believe or who you can trust anymore. So this is where we're coming in with this reasoning and this logic. And we're slowing the momentum down here, and we're looking at the roots of the causes of all evil and why it even had to come to this point to begin with. Okay, do you feel me? These are all in reverse. 12:30 on the screen. We have the Three of Cups in reverse. This is enjoyment, supposed to be, and satisfaction, and celebration, your friends, union. It's in reverse. These are all in reverse. So just imagine what the meaning of these actually mean. King of Wands, Justice, Niagua, beautiful and brave and native. This is the Five of Wands. Conflict, the Lovers, the Knight of Pentacles, the King of Cups, and the Five of Wands. And somebody doesn't want to see you to the victory. Somebody doesn't really want to see you succeed. Oh, shit. But that's not their problem. And the general issue in the manor here. This person's intentions. What's this person's intentions? I think I spoke enough. Okay. The Four of Cups, they want to keep you in the state of limbo, maybe. Maybe because they feel this way with their personal life, that there's not anything going on exciting or new or flowing in. So they kind of want to, they feel some type of way about it, because they're not gaining what you're gaining. Your Ten of Pentacles here. Adults. Knight of Wands. Passion. Fire. Fire over that temperance card. And then we have the Two of Swords. Having to make a decision. And we have the Queen of Cups right underneath that. It's this Nine of Wands and Ten of Pentacles here. Somebody's fury and frustration, I feel like. They're not, Nine of Cups. They're kind of Nine of Wands and Ten of Pentacles, so. They're impractical. They're basically impractical. There's no use in reasoning or even trying at this point to communicate with a person. Is they're kind of just bowling their stubborn-headed. I'm going to think of that. A magician. What's a magician in the Four of Swords here? Really, person? What are they? What's being manifested? What's going to be the outcome? Are they coming towards you? Yeah, they want reconciliation. They want the final straw in the matter, so to speak, as far as this relationship is concerned. What's this chariot and the dark card? They want to claim territory. They want that to be known. You are theirs and nobody else's. Because you are their star, you are their person. But they just can't seem to come up with the reasons or the answers as to why they do what they do. They cheat, they flirt with other people, or simply aren't faithful to you. And treat you like shit when in reality they love you. So why aren't they showing this? This is Knight of Wands and Page of Cups. Why aren't they showing this? Why aren't they showing this? I feel like fear is on the way. Yeah. Some sort of fear. It could be childhood trauma, something from the past. Could be old beliefs. Six of Wands, yeah. I think on this for a minute. They feel like if they give you their cup, that you're going to take advantage of them. Maybe like someone lost it from the past, somebody from the past maybe took advantage of them and left them scared and battle wounded. What's this Page of Cups on the Four of Wands here? Four of Wands and Page of Cups. Does this person want a future with you? Does this person want a future? Does this person want a future with you? Do they want a future with you? What's the problem? This person may drink or resort back to things that aren't good for them, that are toxic and that are poison, drugs, possibly. They try to get you off your mind to reason with themselves, and they're just fighting, constantly fighting this time of demons, battle, the back and forth, the game, like not the game, it's nostalgia, but the death card. This is transition, this is letting something go. Okay? This is letting something go. So they definitely want a union with you. It's quite clear and evident here. We're gonna dig more deeper into this. We're gonna get one more card. Yeah, Page of Wands, passion. You are full of passion, and they know this, and they sense it. The line, because that's where they're drawing the line. They're like, enough is enough. I need to step up and be this Emperor energy, be the man I'm supposed to be for my Sagittarius. I'm not fucking diddly battling around. Alrighty. They've been making problems and burdens for you that you. That both of you have been carrying on for what? For nothing, I feel like, more or less. For nothing. Just a fucking rambunctious, onion, and cheat, or do whatever you want to call it. Because of their ego has been. They feel like they're relaxing something and they could get it out. And that's not the case here. Right, that's not how you handle and go about a situation. It's really not. I mean, think about it. not how you go about the situation. Don't cheat. You don't go out and suck dick or you lick pussy. Whatever you want to fucking call it. For what? Because you're feeling you're having a bad day. Okay, at the bottom we have the Knight of Pentacles. Leading that is the Fool in reverse. So somebody knows they fucked up big. Big. Okay, big. Made a fucking ass of themselves, a fool. This too shall pass. Crossroads again. They weren't satisfied enough to the point where it caused them to go out and mingle. And that's where they went wrong. Okay, do you hear me? What's gonna happen next? James to others, so to speak. And the two of wands, they're gonna make a decision. They're gonna think very long and hard on this decision too, like that. And the two of cups. You're gonna step up to the plate. You're not having that, and they know this, and they know this 150% of what you're doing. What's this ending? Yeah, the champion. They're gonna try. They're gonna try. I'm towards you, but what is your reaction? What's your response to that? Five cups. You're still not over how they treated you and what they've done to you and treated you. Death card and the Five of Cups here. You know they've done you wrong. You might just move on. You might not take it. Do you? For one, yeah. Knight of Cups and the Four of Wands. One more. For the overall outcome. Thank you. Yeah. Three of Wands. You're looking in a new direction for your independence. Your Seven of Swords. And your Seven of Wands with the Star card. On top of that, we have the Six of Cups. Followed by the Seven. Yeah, you're rising higher and higher with each plane. Seven of Cups and the Five of Wands. Okay. Because you know it's ending is worth it in the end, and that's all I've got for you guys. Thank you for today. Thank you.